We knew it was going to be big. Any of us knew that this was the amount of cutting that would be needed, the amount of months of making. The fact that each print has a booklet of 28 pages telling you how to put it together. And it has been, I mean, I've always been very guilty about it. My job is to do the drawing and to discuss with everyone how the cutting should be used. And then a year later, many people have worked extremely hard for the print to be made. But it's been an astonishing discovery of a new medium, the first time I've done it, and either of us have woodcuts, and to see how that could shift. And, I mean, if you're working with line or copy, you can generally rely on it on lying still, behaving still. And wood is completely reconstituted. It gets a bit of dampness and it shifts its shoulder, and it's lying quietly next to each other, and suddenly it's like it's over. And both a way of learning how to deal with it, which has been an astonishing process of printing. That's why we said in Chadwick, this one really needs to have two more pieces of print here. You can hit on the side and then you can get it from ink it up more on that section there. There's a real art in all the stages of translating from that drawing onto each block, and then the carving each block, and then the printing of each block. And what this does, this is crazy thing, it's a ground matter, how it was together. With many sheets of acetate, you've done how the blocks fit together, and how the sheets of paper fit on the block, and what the overlap is, and then the editing of it, when the first cutting is basically done, and it's pinned on the wall, there's a whole separate stage of editing, of adding extra sheets of paper, of adding pieces of white paper, some of which get cut into the block, like the white paper. Some which get added as a separate sheet of paper, as an actual collage on top of the print. So that at each stage is a kind of organic moving object until finally, I guess, when this stage is done, it's pretty set and it's done. So they're fragments from other prints which are used if we need a particular grain of wood or a particular darkness. And we can fragment like that, make up from the different prints, that make up from one of the other wood blocks entirely. Put them together. And it's a project that this part started in 2016. The initial project for the Tigray Rome, which is this image of the base, started, I guess, around 2000, I think. The block itself, the shape of this particular image, came at the end of the process of making the triumphs and dimensions. It's traced most of the figures out onto the walls of the Tigray River. And there was a gap of about 6 meters or 10 meters, which was empty because I got the distance wrong. And I thought, what can we do with it? I don't have a clue. And I don't have a clue at this point. I mean, so filled with the added history of each side, I was able to run. Okay, that which I could not remember, of course, the superstition. So it stands in both for that kind of mental block, but also for all those bits of history we don't really want to think about or talk about and hide from ourselves, that which we do not remember. Which is why it has the Italian title, Carpentine, although it's got the English surtitle on the side. It obviously refers, as it says in the image there, to that image of the black square which Malevich made, the suprematist image of just a black square on a canvas. And the interesting thing about this kind of this perfect form of the black square that Malevich painted, I was delighted to discover very recently that in fact it had come not out of this pure spirituality of art but had been used on a costume design. Piece of theater that he was in. And somebody said, gosh, it's so beautiful, just a plain square with a white shirt. And he said, well, that's too much, just a plain black square with a white shirt. Just trust me, do it, it's going to be great. And then he did it, and it became a great icon, the great icons of 20th century. So there's a kind of a mess. This is like taking the black square and finding the mess inside around the edges of it. The two blocks that we're working on now to form one image, although they'll be two separate blocks and frames of two separate images, will most probably, unless madness strikes, then will be responsive in the chat, the last of this particular series, but in a way that's really, because it means there are many, many other techniques, mediums, materials to set us all to work on it.
At the very beginning, we said that we would do 12.
And I think someone's going to assist us. And it was good work. Like a sword in between the dishes. So thank you so much, David.
Thank you.
Thank you.